Bonjour.
Bonjour.
No.
Time for bladder check. Check.
So it's a show?
It's a lifestyle.
It's a religion.
My emotions! My emotions!
I'm still French.
Ouais, c'est pas faux.
I'm a woman, Mary. I can be as contrary as I choose.
Non, moi je crois qu'il faut que vous arrêtiez d'essayer de dire des trucs.
I'm so excited. Stop. Hello, hi, I'm Laura. I'm gonna watch Peaky Blinders season 5, episode 1. I'm so excited to be back with Peaky Blinders. I love this show so much. If you don't know me, I didn't present myself. If you don't know me, I'm Laura, I'm French. I'm making reaction videos in English and I made reaction videos for all of the seasons of Peaky Blinders because I binge-watched this show during, I think it was May and June or maybe April and May. And I made reaction videos about this show, so for those of you who already knew me, you saw myself falling in love with this show and with this family, the Chelvis family. I love them so much, all of them. I cried so much when, I'm not gonna spoil you if you don't know the show. No, come on, you know the show, you are watching this reaction video. Okay, I cried a lot when John died. It's I'm still not recovering from it. And I really cried also a lot when I thought that Arthur died. He didn't die. I hated him during 1 second to just make me believe that he died. But after that, I really loved him again. If you want to see my reaction video about that moment, I'm gonna put the link because really, I lost at myself during the editing of this video because it was funny seeing me like that, like crying and like saying that, I hate you, no, I love you, I'm sorry. But we are back with the Chelvis family for this season 5. I made a reaction video for the trailer of the season 5. Again, I'm gonna put the link if you're interested. But I didn't watch the sneak peek that we had about this episode 1 because if you don't know me, you don't know it yet. But I'm not watching trailers for episodes or I'm not watching any sneak peeks or things like that. I'm watching trailers for seasons, but that's all. Because I love the show that I am watching, I really love it and I want to be surprised by all of it, all of the moments, all of the scenes, all of the pictures, all of the lines, all of the musics. I want to be surprised by really all of it, so I'm trying to really avoid any kind of spoilers by watching trailers or watching sneak peeks or stuff like that. Even promotional pictures, I'm not watching them. It's really hard to not have any kind of spoilers, but so far I'm doing great with that, so I really just watched the trailer and you saw me. I spoke during 20 minutes about the trailer because I was really afraid of something during the trailer. You know, we saw the explosion just in the front of Tommy's house. We saw a car on fire and we saw Tommy holding someone on his arm and we saw Tommy watching a grave with a little girl. So I'm really afraid about who died. Someone is dying, someone is dead, and I'm afraid of that because for me the person on Tommy's arms, it was a male character, and it was someone young. I can't think that it can be Finn. You know, if you don't know me yet, you don't know, but if you know me, you know how much I love Finn with all of my heart. I'm gonna be broken if it's Finn. I can't think that it's Finn. And for me, the person on Tommy's arms was younger, so maybe it was Charlie, it was Yes, for me it was Charlie. I'm not a fan of the idea that Charlie is gonna die. I don't want that to happen. Of course, I don't want a little boy to die. But I have to be honest, between Charlie and Finn, I'm choosing Finn to live, to survive. But someone, one of you, said to me on the comments about the reaction video, about the trailer, that maybe the person on the arms of Tommy was not dead. Tommy just saved that person, but still there is someone dead in the car, and that's why we saw after that Tommy looking at a grave, and maybe that someone can be Lizzie, and that's why Tommy is looking at a grave with a girl, a little girl, his little girl maybe, that he had with Lizzie, and that's why they are both looking at a grave. And again, I'm not a fan of this idea because I really, really loved Lizzie during the last season. I really loved the evolution of her character. I loved that. And for me, she was a good one for Tommy, you know. You know how much I hated Grace, really. For me, yes, she was a good one for Tommy, and I don't want her to die, because even for her own character, I mean, the evolution of her character was so great that, yes, I don't want her to be dead. But again, if I have to choose between Lizzie and Finn, I'm choosing Finn to survive. Always. You have to know it, always. I'm gonna choose Finn to survive, always. So we'll see about that. I'm so excited to see what was gonna happen during this new season. We're gonna have another time jump. Now we are used to that with Peaky Blinders, and I think that it can be clever to have a time jump right there, because to me, at the end of the season 4 was just elected, so I don't want to have a moment where he's gonna discover the politics and all of that. No, I think that we're gonna have a time jump, and him being fully in his new place, in his new role, you know, in his new character, being a deputy, I think it was a deputy. And I cannot wait to see Ada! I love her character, I love Ada so much. Oh! I was gonna say between Ada and Finn, wow, I can't. It's like choosing between my sister and my brother, I can't. Ada, she's in my heart since the beginning, I love her character so much. And Polly, I cried during each one season for Polly for so many reasons. I want her during this season to be okay, in our mind, in our life. I want her to be okay, to be just happy. Can she have that? She deserves that. She deserves the world. She deserves a moment where she's just happy. So we'll see about that. The other thing that I thought about this new season that can be interesting is the fact that Michael went to America, you know, because they want to make a business in America, and they spoke about Al Capone during the last season, during the season 4, so maybe we're gonna have stuff about that. Don't tell me if you read papers or informations about that. Don't tell me, please, in the comments what you know about that, because again, I don't want to have spoilers about what is gonna happen during the episodes. I want to discover it, so please make this effort. Don't tell me on the comment that yes, they're gonna meet Al Capone, or no, they're not gonna meet Al Capone, but they're gonna meet someone else, another character, another important character. I don't want to know! I want to discover it during the episode. We only have 6 episodes for each season of Peaky Blinders, so if we are beginning to have any kind of spoilers for the season, really, we know already all the season, we know what it's gonna be about. I don't want that. I want really to discover all of that. I'm so excited! You can't know how much I'm excited to be with this family again. I really fall in love with this family. Okay, I'm really excited, but I'm also really stressed because of this person on Tommy's arms. The fact that he was looking at a grave, and oh, also the person on a cross at the beginning of the trailer. I'm stressed because of that. I'm stressed, but I'm more excited than I'm stressed. So it's gonna be great. Enough talking. I'm gonna watch the episode right now. I'm so happy. Let's go for the episode 1 of the season 5 of Peaky Blinders. It's the first time that I'm watching a new episode of Peaky Blinders, and I have to wait after that to see the episode 2. It's the first for me, really, and it's gonna be really hard for me to wait for having the episode 2. I'm so used to see all of the season in just one day or two, so it's gonna be hard, but I can do it, and I want to do it. I want to know what's gonna happen for this beautiful family that I love so much. Let's go for the episode 1. It was so nice. Okay. We're back with the fucking Peaky Blinders. We're back with them. And everybody is alright. So far, everybody is alive. That's great. Okay, let's think about everything that happened during this episode. We have a lot of storylines, a lot of issues for this new season. We have a political issue because we see that this Mosley character is going to be someone important for the next episode. So we have a political issue, we have a financial issue. They are broke, they just lost a lot of money in New York because Michael didn't listen to Tommy, so that's gonna be another issue. What Tommy is gonna do with Michael, because Michael is gonna come back to England, so that's gonna be another issue. But really, the financial issue is gonna be a real big thing, because Tommy said that he has a plan, but what plan, really, to make money when everybody is broke and you are broke also? So we'll see about that. We have Ada, who is pregnant. We have Finn, who is trying to prove himself to everyone, and that's, I don't like that, but he took a bullet just right here in the first episode. He's not gonna take another one, or he's not gonna die in the other episode, so we'll see about that. We've got Arthur and Linda, who are not an happy couple anymore, but I hope that they're gonna reconcile during this season. We have Charlie, who is really not listening to his father, and who is really doubting about his father because he knows that his father is killing people, is killing horses. But the grave that we saw during the trailer was not a person, a human grave. It was the grave for the horse, so I'm so happy about that. That's a really good news, really a good news. We have also an Elsie issue with Tommy. He's taking drugs or medicine, but he's hallucinating because he's seeing Grace. You know how much I didn't like her during the season 1, during the season 2, during the season 3. She was fucking annoying for me. A lot during season 2. During season 1, really, just I didn't care about her. She was not an interesting character for me. She was too cliché for me, so I didn't like her. During season 2, she was fucking annoying. She was doing all the bad things. Really, I didn't like anything that she did. She was lying again. She was betraying everyone. She was a pain in the ass for me, really. During the season 3, I didn't care about her, and I was sad when she died, not because of her character, but because of the fact that Tommy was happy because of her and because of Charlie. So I was feeling sorry for him much more than sorry for her. I thought that we had enough. I had enough of her, so I thought we were over her. We were finished with her, and she's back, and she's an hallucination telling to Tommy that she had to listen to the voices in his head. Is it really a good thing? Again, she's fucking annoying. So yes, we're gonna have an LC, mental LC issue with Tommy right here. So we have the Angels of Retribution also. We have this journalist issue. I don't think that it's gonna be over with it, you know. Just killing him right here, I'm not sure it was a good move, a clever move. Maybe he told someone about this interview. Maybe he told someone about his research on Tommy. I mean, in the newsroom, to his chief, to his... I don't know. I feel that it was not a clever move and something wrong is gonna come because they just chose to kill him. I understand why they did it, but yes, we'll see about that. Okay, so the grave was really not a human grave. I'm so happy about that. But still, we have at least one explosion and the car on fire and Tommy holding someone in his arms. But again, maybe the person in his arms is not really dead and maybe someone is dead in the car. I'm still wondering about that. With this episode, we can see how Finn is and we can see how Charlie is. And for me, the person in the arms of Tommy, it's Charlie. You know, for me, really, the person in his arm, it's Charlie. And also because of the relationship that we can see between the son and the father, the fact that maybe he's gonna save him, or maybe Charlie is gonna die. It's logical with what we saw about them, about their relationship during this episode. But again, did he save him or is he really dead? And if he saved him, someone else is in the car or not? I'm still wondering about that. I'm still afraid of that. Heida is pregnant. I'm so happy for her. My baby is pregnant with a baby. Again. Is it really an issue that she's pregnant with a black man and they're not married? I mean, back then it was an issue, but for the Chelbys family, I mean, they all made stuff like modern stuff that were not accepted during these days. So are you really gonna judge her because of that? But she's really liking him, you know, the father of her child. She's really liking him. We can see that she wanted to flirt with him, or at least that she was, you know, she was liking him. So I'm happy about that. You know, the fact that she just finds someone that she likes. I love that. So yes, it was a really great episode and we have a lot of storylines and a lot of issues to deal with during this season. The financial one, the politic one, the family one, of course, the Angels of Retribution, the pregnant thing. Charlie, Finn, who is trying to prove himself. Arthur, who is the director of the company, but not really. All of that, it's gonna be interesting to follow during this season. I cannot wait to see more about that. And again, we have all of these storylines, but we have also evolutions already and to come for each one of the characters, and that's why I love this show, because they are building storylines, they are writing storylines for each season, but they are also taking the time to make evolutions for their characters between the time jumps, but also during the season, and I love that. They are really managing that really well to make the storylines and the evolution of the characters at the same level, and well, it's well balanced, you know, so it's great. Oh, it was so great! I'm so happy to be back with the Chelvis family. I love them so much, each one of them, and I'm really relieved about that thing about the grave. It's a Norse grave. Okay, it's not someone that we know. It's great. But I'm still wondering, I'm still afraid about that fire on the car and that person that Tommy is holding. I'm still hoping that it's gonna be alright. Okay, so tell me what did you think about this first episode, if you are like me, really excited by it, and if you loved it like me, tell me that. So it's all for Peaky Blinders for today. I have to wait one entire week to see what's gonna happen next. It's really new for me to wait to see what is next for Peaky Blinders, but I'm so excited about it, so that's alright. So it's all for Peaky Blinders for today, and it's all for me for now, so bye for now, bye.
Wait a minute, Doc. Are you telling me that you built a time machine?
Great.